Hello everybody, my name is Eric D. Johnson, also on the bright shine right here in the city of Memphis, in the county of the state of Tennessee. Today is early Monday morning, January the 6th, 2020. The time, 2:34 a.m. First, I thank all my family, my support, for your continued current support. I'll continue to keep myself employed right here in the Memphis tri-state area, and continue to further my education and moral cause online, continue to pursue my social degree, study, being administrator, concentrate, market, this spare time, take a break, going to school, ready to be in the future. I will be going back to moral cause online, and continue to pursue my social degree, study, being administrator, concentrate, and market. Now, like I said, you know, it's early Monday morning, January the 6th, 2020, and it's all about how we manage the time. So the title of this book is West African Traditional Religion. It was written by Dr. Joseph Omosane Welelu, Dr. P. Adenumo Lebemu. And the title of this book, African Traditional Religion, a definition written by Dr. E. Beloja Adobu. Title of this book, African Religion and Philosophy, written by Dr. John S. M. Beatty. And the title of the book is titled Concepts of God in Africa, written by Dr. John S. M. Beatty. We're going to go to the Holy Bible and we're going to say the Lord's Prayer. Now the Lord's Prayer is in the Holy Bible, in the New Testament, the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 9 through 13, also the book of Luke, chapter 11, verses 2 through 4. So we're going to go to the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 9 through 13. And the Lord's Prayer, and it reads, with like I said, we're in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 9 through 13. After this manner, therefore, pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Like I said, that's the Lord's Prayer in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 9 through 13. You can also go to the book of Luke, chapter 11, verses 2 through 4. Now, this is a world map of all the people on the earth. World map of all the people on the earth. This is a language distribution map of all the languages in Africa. And this also is a language distribution map of all the languages in Africa. This also is a language distribution map for all the languages in Africa. This is an Afro-Asiatic language distribution map. This also is an Afro-Asiatic language distribution map. This is a Nilo-Saharan language distribution map. And this also is a Nilo-Saharan language distribution map. Now this is a Niger-Congo language distribution map. This is a Niger-Congo language distribution map. This is an Albanian language map. And this is a Baltic language distribution map. This is a Greek language map. And this is a Slavic language map. And this is the Altaic language map. Now this is a Ural-Altaic language map. This is the Romanian language map. Now the Romanian language is a Latin Romance language. And as you know, Romani is also known as Wallachia in the Romanian language. Now we continue to do our Bible study, and so we're going to continue to refer back to the Old Testament in the book of Genesis chapter 15, and it reads, "After these things the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision, saying, Fear not, Abram, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. And Abram said, Lord God, what wilt thou give me, seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eleazar of Damascus? And Abram said, Behold, to me thou hast given no seed, and lo, one born in my house is my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, This shall not be thine heir, but he that shall come forth out of thine own bowels shall be thine heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, Look now toward heaven and tell the stars, that thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, So shall thy seed be. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it to him for righteousness. And he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of Ur of the Chaldees to give thee this land to inherit it. And he said, Lord God, whereby should I know that I should inherit it? And he said unto him, take me and help her 3 years old, and a she goat of 3 years old, and a ram of 3 years old, and a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. And he took unto him all these, and divided them in the midst, and laid these pieces one against another. But the birds divided him not. And when the fowls came down upon the carcass, Abram drove them away. And when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abram, and lo, and horror of great darkness fell upon him. And he said unto Abram, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them. Will I judge, and afterwards shall they come out in great suffering? And thou shalt go to thy fathers in peace. Thou shalt be buried in a good old age. But in the fourth generation they shall come hither again. For the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet full. And it came to pass that when the sun went down and it was dark, behold, a smoking furnace and a burning lamp that passed between those beasts. In the same day the Lord made a covenant with Abram, saying, unto thy seed have I given this land, from the river of Egypt unto the great river, the river Euphrates, the Kenites, and the Kenizzites, and the Canaanites, and the Hittites, and the Perizzites, and the Rephaims, and the Amorites, and the Canaanites, and the Girgashites, and the Jebusites. Now we know. Now we just read from the Old Testament, the book of Genesis, chapter 15. There are many people mentioned, and as you know, when you read the book of Genesis, we read about Adam and Eve, and Cain and Abel, and let me turn back here. And Seth, and you know all their genealogy and all the generations after Adam and Eve and their children. Then we get to the Noah, the flood story. So and like I said, the three sons of Noah, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And so Then we get to Abraham, Abram, and Abraham, and so on and so forth. So And it continued, and it mentioned these ancient people, the Amorites, the Kenites, the Canaanites, the Kenizzites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Rephaims, the Canaanites, the Girgasites, the Jebusites. And then when you mention all these people, then there are other people also. When you do research on these people, these ancient people, like the Hurrians, because people live around the land of Canaan, you know, in their land, the Horites, and there are many other, the Amalekites. And when you do research on these people, you find that many of these people, they get classified by language, and then some people, you know, they can't classify them by language, period, but based on historical record in the Bible, then there are archaeological evidence about these people. Then we able to study these people and their culture, their way of life. For, you know, the Amalekites, Amalek, and some people, you know, like the Amorites, they are considered, classified as being Afro-Asiatic. However, the Hittites are classified as being Indo-European. But the Hittites and the Amorites were both, you know, like neighbors in the land of Canaan. And so, and then you had the Rephaims, then you had the Canaanites, who were also living in the land of Canaan. And you had the Kenites, who were nomadic people. They were not stationary. They were nomadic. And you had Kenizzites and the Canaanites. They were all ancient people. And as far as classifying these people, they're not classified as being, you know, by language. They're not classified as being Afro-Asiatic or Indo-European or anything. Just, they are considered to be ancient people. The Kenites are a Kenite, and a Canaanite is a Canaanite, and the Kenizzite is a Kenizzite. And also the Perizzites. As far as we know about a Perizzite. And how, I know this big question mark will be like, well, how is it that these ancient people live next to the Amorites, who are classified as being Afro-Asiatic, and the Rephaims? The Rephaims are considered to be giants in the Bible. And that's all it says, that they're giants, now classified by language. Not something that the scholars, you know, scholars have not been able to classify the Rephaim by language. But they mentioned in the Holy Bible being giants, and they live in the land of Canaan. Now I know, again, there's going to be a big question mark, like, well, how did they communicate with the Canaanites and with the Girgasites and with the Jebusites and with the Canaanites? And then you had the Kenites, the Kenizzites, the Perizzites, ancient people. So it's going to be a big question mark about the Rephaim or Rephaite, about how did they communicate with the other. First of all, how did they communicate with each other, first of all? And then how did they communicate with other people who were not Rephaims? And so we're going to continue our Bible study on these ancient people that we find mentioned in the Holy Bible, and how the ancient people, you know, express their reverence to a supreme being. You had these various groups of people, and this expression of reverence to a supreme being. You know, this goes all the way back. This goes all the way back to ancient times. And, you know, we have these man-made religions today. For example, what they say, Islam, anti-Semitic to the will of God, Muslim, one who entirely submits their will to God. The so-called Jew, and Christianity, and the Black Hebrew Israelite. There's no such thing. No such thing. Rastafari. There's no such thing. Man, it's a man-made religion. Man-made religion is a lie. It's a lie. Some junk. And then what we also had to address when we talk about ancient people expressing reverence to the supreme being, what is this other supreme being? This wicked, so-called wicked entity. So, you know, we're going to continue our Bible study, and we're going to continue to get more and more into this, to ancient peoples and their expression of reverence to a supreme being. And also that also includes this idea of this other entity being, you know, what we could say as being evil. So we're going to continue our Bible study. As we continue to do our Bible study, continue to study the first century. Now, Chicago, Illinois, state of Illinois, that history of Chicago, Illinois, the history of Illinois, the history of the United States of America. We just went into the Bible, the Holy Bible, the history of ancient people, and this so-called devil, Satan. No such thing as Satan. You know, putting ism on the end of Satan. No such thing as devil and worship. See, you don't put words together. You be lying. And it just didn't start as you know it. It goes back to ancient times. History of Chicago, the west side of Chicago, south side of Chicago, northeast, you know what I'm saying? People moving to the city of Chicago and to other northern cities, to Detroit, to Milwaukee, Wisconsin, to Minneapolis, Minnesota, to Iowa, to the state of Iowa, and to Indianapolis, Indiana, and so on and so forth. People just, you know, left the South. And many people, family members moved from Texas and from Louisiana, from Alabama, from Tennessee, Arkansas, Mississippi, you know, from Kentucky, Missouri, and moved to the state of Illinois, moved to Chicago and other northern cities, even to Ohio, Cleveland, Cincinnati, Ohio, so on and so forth. And but mainly to the city of Chicago. And African American, Hispanic, Latino, and other, even including European Americans who were living in the South, and just like we said, they also moved to the north, to the northern cities, and to Chicago as well. The history of Chicago, the Imperial Chaplains, the 14th Street Clothing. And I mean, you know, we hear about that the Will and Sheba's and the Four Corners, you know, the history of Chicago. And also in the history of Chicago, we done heard about the Black Syndicate. We heard about that in the city of Chicago. That's the history of Chicago. Of Chicago and the Imperial Chaplains and the 14th Street Clovers. As you know, over a period of time, the Imperial Chaplains became the Imperial Vice Lords, the 14th Street Clover became the insane vice lord. And next it became the Imperial Insane Vice Lord. You know what I'm saying? And as you know, the Egyptian Cobras, they really came from, you know, they are from the Imperial Chapters. And over periods, excuse me. And they began to get into altercations with the Vice Lords. But over a period of time, the Egyptian Cobras and the Vice Lord signed the truce, and even today, they both know the Mickey Cobras and the Vice Lord, they are in the My People Alliance, or, you know, and you know, the history of Chicago, the Lord's Stone Disciples Alliance, that was they came together during the Civil Rights Movement, and all these different street organizations tried to come together, and then you know after that you had the Folk Alliance and the My People Alliance. And it's still today. But what you don't hear in the history scholar, you don't hear nothing about no blood gang, no Crip gang, and bloodstone, limestone. You don't hear nothing like that. See? It's that East Coast bitch. Saying doing background check. See, when people see things for themselves, they see the wrong that other people do for themselves. You know, something like that, always like that, always saying, you know, you can tell people things, but when it's a different when you see it yourself. You become evident of the wrong that others do to you as well as to others. That's what that East Coast bitch done and be doing. Be doing people wrong. See, that's the history of Chicago. It makes a difference. Because when you be out here in the city of Memphis, in the countyship, in the state of Tennessee, and then you have other parts of Tennessee, see, you have people that be moving around from the East Coast, and they lie. They lie. They be lying. People talking about they from Chicago, and they ain't from Chicago. They're from the East Coast. And so, like I said, it'll be them East Coast bitches be lying, trying to claim it. They'll tell people in different parts of the state of Tennessee, they'll go to Arkansas, Mississippi and lie. They'll go to Texas and lie. They'll be down, they'll go to Oklahoma and lie. Tell people, I'm from Chicago. You be lying. Then walk around trying to tell somebody. You could be in the blood gang, in the crib gang, you be lying. Talk about some bloodstone, limestone. But when you look up in Chicago, you don't see them. You see the Fulton lines and the My People lines. Doing background checks. Identify and expose the East Coast bitch. Stuff about some devil and worship and all this Satan and all. There's only one thing. See, you be horse playing, trying to be a smart ass. There's no such thing. There's no such thing as worship and devil. No such thing as no ism and Satan. You lying. You be lying. You see, that one going, it's going to be severe consequence and repercussion. You're lying. There's no such thing. All that esotericism and all that other junk you made up, the occult. You're lying. You're lying. Just like the Catholic Church be lying. And all them Protestant churches, you be lying, and that's the Catholic Church. The American Restoration Movement, Stone Camel Movement, you lying. The Church of Christ lying. All you doing is lying. There's no such thing as no Church of Christ. You lying. Islam, you lying. Muslim, lying. Black Hebrews, like Jew, you lying. You just lying. And all the rest of them, you lying. Rastafari, you lying. There's only one church. The church that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Son of God, established. And that church never did go away. First of all, it wasn't wrong. That church was right. And it is right. See, the problem is you as an individual, you are a sinner. You commit sin. You being sinful. You as an individual being defiant and being disobedient to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Son of God. That's what the problem is. say this is the history of Chicago. This is really why I do this. It's the history of Chicago. And when people lie, that's what you be doing, you be lying. Because see, this is not something like in the past. This today. This today. When I show these videos, this today. This today. The focal lines and a lot of people lies. You see all the disciples. You see the stones. It's today. And you see all of my people. It's today. It's not something like yesterday. It's today. You see what's been going on is that this East Coast bitch been coming up to Chicago, to the state of Illinois, and to the surrounding states, as well as other parts of like Los Angeles, California. The East Coast bitch lying. And then you call it, see, the East Coast bitch tried to use devil and worship and Satanism, and try to use the occult. Like that's their doctrine. See, that goes there. See, it didn't start on the East Coast. See, when you think about them pirates, see, the Native Americans, the first Americans were living over here. There wasn't no Europeans over here. Then the Europeans came over and settled here on the East Coast and started colonizing America. And when they came over, see, the pirates came over. A lot of the pirates were over in Cilicia. They was over there in Cilicia transporting African slaves. First you had the East African slave trade. Then you had the West African or transatlantic slave trade. And the pirates were bringing slaves from sub-Saharan Africa to the New World first, to the Caribbean, to Mexico, Central and South America, and the Caribbean, and later, to the 13 colonies, and then to the other parts of America. As the 13 colonies began to expand, start having other states. Then you had start having us African slaves being transported, not just to the East Coast of America, but through those slave ports in the South, like Galveston, Texas, New Orleans, Louisiana, the state of Mississippi, Veracruz, Mexico, slave ports. African slave being transported. But see, when it comes to that so-called occult, devil worship, Satanism, for example, voodoo. See, that East Coast bitch. See, you don't get away with lying. You don't get away with horse playing. You don't get away with being a smart ass. There's gonna be severe consequences and repercussions. No such thing as no blood gang, no crip gang. See, it was that East Coast bitch. See, all that. See, when you study it, when you look at the back of the history of America, you see that East Coast bitch. See, everybody, we're doing background check. No background check. We're going off. We're going back. Before the Civil War. After the Civil War. You know, like after the Civil War. 1900s. Then you get up to the World War I, World War II, and all that. You know, a certain period of time, you know, when you do a background check, you have to bring all this certain time period. Because because it seems like when you find that East Coast bitch, then you'll see. You'll see the wrong that the East Coast bitch has done and is doing. Gonna be severe consequences because trying to hide in the city of Chicago, well, a bloodhound will find you. The bloodhound will find you. The bloodhound will find you. Severe consequences and repercussions. See, there's a lot of misconceptions. Basically, a lie. So you had this concept, you had this idea in your head that you're supposed to be going against, some other person or persons. And see, that with all that stupid stuff, that devil worship and Satanism and all the occult. That's what that is. See, it's a lie. See, you lie. You've been lied to. And then you lie. I've been saying, see, in the city of Chicago, there's no such thing, no blood gang, no such thing, no crib gang, no such thing, no bloodstone, limestone, or anything else. All you see in the city of Chicago is my people, and it the folk lines and the my people lines. And see, when you see that East Coast bitch being in the city of Chicago, see, then when you start seeing this other junk, it should have been gone a long time ago. See, don't accept, don't approve, and damn sure don't allow. See, this is how you know. See, when you see the video and when you see the things you see, and when you know that they're still there, and when you see some oddball sticking out, it just don't even, But see, when you see all them other organs, when you see all the stones, and you see all the BGDs, the BGs, the GDs, they all affiliated with each other. They all affiliate. And see, this goes back to the families that came from the South. The overwhelming majority came from the South and moved up north. On the west side of Chicago, the same thing. It goes all the way back to the Imperial Chaplains, the 14th Street Clovers, the Vice Lords, the Egyptian Cobras. That's all you see today. And that includes the Hispanic Latino, that includes the Hispanic Latino, and then think about all these European American with all the greasers organizations. All these years that they've been in the city of Chicago and the state of Illinois and the surrounding state. And then you see a oddball sticking out. From the East Coast, don't accept, don't approve, or don't allow. See, I know what it is. See, it comes from that occult and so-called devil worship, Satanism. There's gonna be severe consequences and repercussions. First of all, there's no such thing. It's a lie. That's all you're doing, lying. And see, when you see the bloodstone, the limestone, that's just a disguise. The blood gang, the crib gang, it's a disguise. That's how the East Coast bitch try to disguise and try to conceal the devil worship, the voodoo, the Satanism. There's no such thing. It's just a bunch of made up lies. You're just lying. Trying to go against other people. You'll be lying. There's going to be severe consequences and repercussions. we talk about voodoo, you know, the Hispanic Latino, talking about some Shinteria. You should know better by now. All the African slaves came over from Sub-Saharan Africa and brought over that voodoo and voodoo in the Hispanic Latino concept, Shinteria. All lies. It's a lie. Trying to go against other people. The devil. Satan. The occult. There's going to be some severe consequences and repercussions. You're lying. Also, as a reminder, don't forget the sorority and fraternity. Just as a reminder, see, that's another reason why you had the problem that we, you know, the issue that we had within the sorority and the fraternity. They be doing the same thing. The sorority and fraternity do the same. The occult. And with all that hazing and those initiation rituals, it's the occult. You think you're in some kind of cult group. Sorority and the fraternity, you know, they are these secret societies from Africa and from Asia and from Europe. See, the occult. They're so-called devil and Satan and all these various people that live on this earth and all this about languages and all these stories that these secret societies be telling. background check. Background check. See, this is when you get to the background check. Background check. Background check. Background check. Background check. Do a background check on them too, so you'll find out a lot of information. See, when you do a background check on them people that was trying to move in on with the Fluke Stokes' territory, the East Coast Beach. East Coast bitch trying to hide from anybody else, trying to hide anywhere in the state of Illinois. That bloodhound will find you. That bloodhound will find you. There ain't nowhere to hide. Or anywhere else. Ain't nowhere to hide. That bloodhound will find you. Background check. Background check. Watch this. Pedro Rodriguez, background check. Background check. How you let somebody get way up to Chicago, Illinois, from South Florida, from outside this country? Background check. Won't know in and everything about Pedro Rodriguez. Don't miss nothing. Don't leave out nothing. Won't know in and everything Pedro Rodriguez. Background check. Background check. background check. That's the reason why it's so important to do background check. Even today, see, when people did things, they thought they were smart. They thought they were so smart that they could even have things being still, you know, the effects. When you kill Fluky Stokes, you understand? You can see the effects of that today. Pedro Rodriguez being involved, and then all the other people who were involved in murdering Fluky Stokes and murdering Fluky Stokes' son, Willie the Wimp. See? Background check. That East Coast bitch. That's what it is. That East Coast bitch, dog cult, devil worship, Satanism. background check. Now, what I'm finna do now, I'm finna do my Instagram. Yeah, I done do my Instagram, do my Periscope. Hello everybody, my name is Eric D. Johnson, host on my bright channel right here in the city of Memphis in the county of state of Tennessee. Dang, dang, it's early Monday morning, January the 6th, 2020 time, 14 a.m. First, I thank all my family for support for your continued care and support. Anti-gang. These are just a few of the free logo design website that you can go to make anti-gang logo. First one, always give thanks to God for all the blessings and guidance He provides us all with. Now when it comes to street slang, gang plus stir, mob plus stir, Merriam-Webster Third International Dictionary and Oxford English Dictionary, it gives you the complete and total definition and meaning of the word gang plus stir and mob plus stir. Then other street slang like boss, goon, thug, crook, hooligan, mac, player, pimp, whore, hustler, nigga, feel, nigga, house nigga, and street slang. Street slang and music, hip hop, rock and roll, swing, groove, jazz, blues, funk, doo-wop, bebop, and street slang. Street slang for music, for money, currency, exchange, bucks, racks, stack, bands, Brand, Doe, Scratch, Luke, Moon, Benjamin, Dan, President, the Street Slang. None official, none writer by no Street Slang. Now, the sorority and the fraternity. United States Department of Justice. Hazing is a crime. The sorority and the fraternity, they use hazing in the initiation ritual. It's the occult. Devil worship, Satanism. There's no such thing as putting words together like Satan and ism and devil and worship. Even the occult. When you say cult by itself, and you put that OC in front of it, and the basis of the sorority fraternity, the whole world secret society from Africa, from Asia, and from Europe. Now the sorority fraternity, they commit crimes on and off the campus. They use and abuse tobacco products. They indulge in gambling and games of chance. They use and abuse alcohol and drugs. They indulge in immoral activity. They indulge in sexual deviant practice. Don't let the sorority fraternity mislead you. And don't be misled by these sorority from these secret societies from Africa, from Asia, and from Europe. I came to Massachusetts. William Mary College in Williamsburg, Virginia, founded February 8, 1693, the second oldest institute of higher learning in the United States of America. Now, Phi Beta Kappa Society, founded December 5, 1776. The College of William and Mary recognized as the first Greek level student society in North America. After the death of Pi, first sorority founded in 1851 West Hancock, Macon, Georgia. The first organization to adopt the word sorority was Gamma Phi Beta, established on November 11, 1874, Syracuse University, Syracuse, New York, and the first women's fraternity in DuPont College in 1870. Now the basis of the sorority and fraternity is the old world secret society from Africa, from Asia, and from Europe. For example, the Eastern Stars and the Freemasons. They're talking about Euclid, the mathematician, then the Alexander E. 1390-1425, mentioned in the Hardaway manuscript. The Reason Poem in the Crook manuscript. Examples of them old world secret societies from Africa, from Asia, and from Europe. Skull and Bone, Rosicrucian, the Sons of the Living, Thug Society, the Proud Scion, Order of Temple Orient, Knights of the Golden Eagle, the Wood, the Ancient Arab Order of the Nose of the Mission Shrine, the Improved Order of Rim, the P.O. Sisterhood, the Eastern Star, the Freemason, the Elves, the Lord Order of Moose, the Bilderberg Group, the Ku Klux Klan, the Knights of Bethia, the Knights of Columbus, the Illuminati, Far Society, the Mystic Order of the Golden Dawn, the Mystic Order of the Veil Prophets of the Enchanted Realm, the United Order of Golden Cross, the United Ancient Order of Druid, Master Brain, the Ancient Order of Hibernate, the Opus Dei, the Knights Templar, the Scottish Rite, the Spanish Garduna, the Carbonari, the Black Hand, you say Mafia, that's Afro-Asian, you say Coastal North, that's Latin, the Triad, the Yakuza, the Osiris, and just a few and some more. The history of Chicago, Illinois, and other parts of America. No such thing, no blood gang, no crib gang, no bloodstone, no limestone, or anything else. All you see in Chicago, the Fulton lines and the Black People line. That East Coast bitch trying to come up to Chicago and North and trying to live around other parts of America. The cult. Devil worship. Satanism. There's no such thing. You lying. Voodoo. Shinteria. It's going to be severe consequence and repercussion. Severe consequence and repercussion. Horse playing. Trying to be a smart ass. Sorority and fraternity. Don't be misled by the sorority and fraternity. They work and they manage the businesses, companies, and corporations. They use and misuse the background check. They commit crimes against humanity, atrocities, and violations of human rights, and civil rights, and humanity, genocide, ethnic cleansing, all forms of discrimination and harassment. They pollute the air, ground, water, as well as noise pollution. They destroy the environment, nature, and wildlife. Don't be misled by the sorority and the fraternity. And don't be misled by these old world secret societies. from Africa, from Asia, from Europe. They started their sorority and their fraternity. That includes them, some of them old world secret societies from Africa, Asia, and Europe. Renounce them. Renounce their whole idea, the whole concept of a sorority and fraternity. Them old world secret societies from Africa, from Asia, and from Europe. Devil worship. Satanism. The occult. See, the history of Chicago, this is the history of Chicago. You don't see no blood gang, no crip gang. You don't see no bloodstone, no limestone, or anything else. The focal lines and the my people lines, that's all you see in the city of Chicago, in the state of Illinois, and the surrounding state, as well as in everywhere else. See, that East Coast bitch using devil worship and Satanism, the occult, as a concealment and as a disguise. And going around trying to call themselves the blood gang, the crip gang, the bloodstone, limestone. Don't accept, don't approve, and don't allow. Retaliate. Retaliate. Retaliate on that blood gang, that crib gang. So-called bloodstone, limestone. Retaliate. is a list of place names of Native American origin in the United States. For example, state names: Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, Arkansas, Connecticut, Hawaii, Idaho, Illinois, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Massachusetts, Michigan, Minnesota, Mississippi, Missouri, Nebraska, New Mexico, North, South Dakota, Ohio, Oklahoma, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Wisconsin, Wyoming. Scroll down to the bottom where it says a list of place names of indigenous origin in America. See, this is the reason why that East Coast bitch, when you be talking about that East Coast, and you be talking about that devil worship and Shintaria and Satanism and the occult. See, when you talk about them pirates, we talk about the Native Americans and the first Americans who are already living here in this part of the world. And people came from the old world, from Europe, from Asia, from Africa, and came over to this world. The pirates were over there in Cilicia. And they were transporting slaves from sub-Saharan Africa to this world, to this part of the earth. All that devil worship and Satanism. Justice, the Office of Juvenile Justice, the Links Prevention, the Bureau of Justice System, the National Gang Center Bulletin, and the title of the book, History of Street Gangs in the United States, written by Mr. James C. Howard, Mr. John P. Moore. Same information on the quick reference Wikipedia title Gangs in the United States. This is the International Bill of Human Rights. On them next all forms of discrimination with women. This is the Declaration of the Rights of the Child. And this is the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child. This is the world's oldest human rights organization, Anti-Slavery International. This is the International Federation for Human Rights. The world's oldest international conservation organization, BirdLife International. First International Wildlife Conservation Organization. Yeah. the world's oldest global environmental organization, International Union for Conservation Nation, also the World Wildlife Fund. Amnesty International, Human Rights Watch, Global Rights Fund, Land Defending Human Rights Without Frontiers, International Center for Human Rights, Conservation International, Wildlife Conservation Society, Conservation Fund, League of Conservation Vote, Earth Watch Institute, Conservative Association, Earth Justice, and Conservation Volunteers, Wildlife Conservation Network, Endangered Wildlife Trust, Biodiversity Nation, Conservative Association, Rare Species Conservation Center, Wildlife Research and Conservation Trust, Rainforest Trust, International Rainforest Conservation Organization, Rainforest Alliance, Rainforest Action Network, Biodiversity Internet, Earth Day Network, Environmental Defense Fund, Friends of the Earth, Friends of Nature, Greenpeace, the Nature Conservancy, the Wildlife Conservation Society, Soil and Water Conservation, Clean Water Action, World Water Council, Marine Conservation Institute, Marine Conservation Alliance, Ocean and Preservation Society, Ocean Society, Global Ocean Commission, the International Marine Life Alliance. That Saul from Tarsus, self-proclaimed Apostle Paul, that he wrote. He's a lying, murdering devil, an occultist. And one of the verses that the man-made religion organization used, that Saul from Tarsus, self-proclaimed Apostle Paul wrote, Romans chapter 16, verse 16, so the one that with that Holy Ghost, the church with the suffix ES, Christ on earth. Chapter 1, verse 4, so we ourselves, Lord, you in the church with the southern end, a God for your pain and fame, all your persecution, tribulation that ye endure. Such thing, devil worship, Satan, there's no such thing. He is the singer of the 18th century. It's a lie. three logo websites that you go to in the anti-gang logo. Get ready to end my Instagram video. Then I'm gonna do my Periscope video. Do right now. I just ended my Instagram video, and so I'm this gonna be part one, and then I'm gonna start part two. Part one is 2 hours and 30 something minutes, almost two. And so like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video, then I'm gonna start part two. Then I'm gonna do my Periscope video. So just give me a quick moment here. Like I said, today's video is going to be dated January the 6th, 2020. It's going to be part one. Mm-hmm.